marching economy, fast-paced developments, crowded markets, malls and supermarkets, buzzing airports, world-class highways, zipping vehicles. India is on the march, but often mismatching this march are such encroachments. They tell the tale of a different city psyche and not the one for which the world is looking up to India. Religious buildings encroaching roads is a common sight in urban India, causing daily traffic snarls, accidents and much more.
Removing them isn't easy, for they cause heartaches and raise religious fervors.
But then roads are meant for traffic, not for prayers. So, solution must be found.
Barring exceptional cases, such encroachments mostly happen out of innocent religious desires. But as the devotees grow, so grows the need of extra land, and ultimately, they become obstacle in traffic movement.
That's the brief story of religious encroachments in most cities of our country. And like any Indian city, this Jabalpur district of Madhya Pradesh too was full of such encroachments, clearing the roads for development purposes by demolishing a total of 566 religious structures was too hot an issue to handle. But then, encroachments must end. That was tough calling for the Jabalpur administration. An order from the Honorable Jabalpur High Court set the ball rolling, which while hearing a public interest litigation, directed the district administration
to remove all such religious encroachments while maintaining peace and tranquility in the city.
When I took over as a district magistrate in Jabalpur, it was in March of 2005, and there was already a PIL pending before the Honorable High Court in Jabalpur. This was about 7-8 months. This was lying before the High Court bench, and no action was initiated because everybody was anticipating a lot of law and order situations cropping up, because particularly Jabalpur is a very community sensitive district, and otherwise also it's always fraught with dangers that religious sentiment along with the economic concerns can always lead to a situation which, when not handled properly, can go out of hand. So not only the administrators but also anybody who was involved into it were fearing that if they take any step in that direction, it might lead to a worsening of a situation. And that was the time when I thought that since it's an opportunity, why not make it happen and give it a very, very decent and a sincere effort to actually let it happen and try it out. So it is just that idea which gave me a start, that I started along with my team thinking about the modalities, the processes, the situations that one has to deal with.
Objectives were twofold: removing illegal encroachment and reclaiming the land, and the other was discouraging the tendency of encroaching the public places.
Armed with the Honorable Court's orders and a steely resolve, the district administration decided to embark on removing all such encroachments. But as past experiences are a testimony, any initiative in this regard means confusion, chaos and curfew, and in extreme cases, even deaths and destruction. In similar situation, 6 people lost their lives and 42 were injured when in the year 2006, religious encroachment in Baroda were removed. The then Jabalpur district collector, Sanjay Dubey, knew that little lax handling may prove otherwise. He needed to have an impeccable plan to meet the challenges. Moreover, he knew for sure that he had to lead from the front and be there round the clock. Further, own the responsibility if something went wrong.
So, for removing encroachment, he opted for wonderful ways of winning the hearts and minds of people, along with meticulously planned approach for actions.
Obvious were the results. By June 2008, in a short span of 2.5 years' time, 311 of the 566 religious encroachments were removed. But the most pleasing thing was that let alone deaths, not even a bruise was caused to anybody. So how was this wonder achieved? Well, this amazing Jabalpur journey with such pleasing results had many ups and downs, many hopes and hurdles. As most efforts made in past had not shown the right results, a brand new approach was a must to recover and reclaim the valuable government land and facilitated development works in the town of Jabalpur.
इस पूरे प्रोसेस में पहला तो यह है कि नगर निगम का बड़ा क्रूशियल रोल रहा है, क्योंकि हमारा जो अतिक्रमण दस्ता होता है, एनक्रोचमेंट स्क्वाड होता है, उसी के द्वारा सारी कार्रवाई की जाती है। और लोगों से जो पहले चर्चा करना है, उनको विश्वास में लेना है और उनको ये बताना है कि इस धार्मिक स्थल के हटने से हमारी यहाँ फ्यूचर प्लानिंग क्या है डेवलपमेंट की, ये बड़ा महत्वपूर्ण था। उसमें हमारे स्टाफ ने लोगों से मिल के बात करके उनको विश्वास में ले के इस काम को प्रारंभ किया।
Primary comes the city's peace. So administration's first and foremost thought was removal of encroachments without hurting the religious sentiments of the people. For sensitive issue of removal of religious structures of different communities had a potential of engulfing the entire city's population in chaos, and that could create a law and order problem. So the cornerstone of entire plan had to be taking the people along.
What we thought of is that first we have to size up this problem. We have to do a simple enlisting of these encroachments. And for that, we thought that there has to be one person from the revenue authorities who has the land records with them. There has to be one person from a municipal authority because they also have land records within the town area. And also a police authority so as to see that what kind of a reaction might come up at the very beginning. So it's not only the enlisting of an exercise whereby we have to size how many actually have to go out and how many of them are under encroachment, we also tried to assess what kind of a reaction might come up from the sympathizer of these places.
Now, fear of public reprimand was further confounded as various components of administration in general appeared non-committal for obvious reasons. So getting both people and administration on board was the first priority. For they are the ones who mostly belonged to the very city and had to remain integrated with their very own socio-cultural existence of the city. First was the need of convincing the people within the administration and simultaneously following up on the groundwork for implementation of High Court's orders.
सबसे पहले तो हमारे जो टीम के सदस्य हैं, उनमें ये भय था कि हम मंदिर को हटाने जा रहे हैं, हम मजार को हटाने जा रहे हैं, तो इसमें कहीं हम पर या हमारे परिवार के ऊपर किसी प्रकार की विपत्ति तो नहीं आएगी। फिर उनको ये कॉन्फिडेंस उनमें पैदा किया कि नहीं, ये माननीय न्यायालय का निर्देश है और हम पब्लिक के हित में इनको हटा रहे हैं। तब उसके बाद में हमारी टीम के सदस्य फील्ड में गए, वहाँ पर जो मंदिर प्रबंध कमेटी के सदस्य हैं उनसे चर्चाएं की। चर्चा के दौरान भी हमारे सामने कई कठिनाइयां आईं। उनके द्वारा कहा गया कि आप पहले ये मजार हटाएं, उसके बाद में हमारा मंदिर हटाएं। मजार वालों ने कहा कि पहले आप मंदिर हटाएं, उसके बाद इसमें हाथ लगाएं।
Seeing the complexities of the issue, the implementation process had to be multi-layered. It was 1. Identification of religious structures. 2. Involving common citizens of the city. 3. Identification of men behind the curtain. 4. Organizing peace committee meetings. 5. Well-prepared teams. 6. Planning the demolition of encroaching structures. 7. Respecting the sanctity of religious sentiments. And 8, initiation and completion of developmental work. Now work started at both the levels involving administrative machinery as well as citizenry. At administrative level, identification of all such structures was the first priority, and the guiding principle was that identification had to be unbiased and impartial, and each and every structure that had been built on a government land had to be figured out irrespective of religious sect it belonged to. Teams of municipal, police and revenue officials were put on survey of their areas for listing illegally encroached religious structures. The data was further corroborated by the respective SDMs and CSPs. Data thus acquired was further refined after due deliberations among the officials. Taking common people of the city in confidence was a must, and to achieve that, a multi-pronged strategy was adopted. One of them was that people must know it is about all the illegal religious encroachments of all the communities and not a structure or a particular community's structure. People were divided into two groups. One, a silent majority, who was aware of the problems because of these encroachments but could not dare to speak.
मैं किसी सिलसिले में गया था कलेक्टर, तो संजय दुबे जी कलेक्टर थे, उनसे मेरी बात हुई, तो उन्होंने बताया कि ये ऐसा हम करना चाहते हैं, जो सड़कें चौड़ी करना है, तो उसमें कुछ मजहबी जो इमारतें हैं वो भी आएंगी। तो उसी वक्त मेरा ये कहना था कि इनको तोड़ना बहुत ज़रूरी है, मगर किसी के साथ नाइंसाफ़ी ना हो। उसके बाद बिल्कुल मेरे ख्याल से कहीं नाइंसाफ़ी नहीं हुई। अगर ईदगाह की दीवारें टूटी हैं तो मंदिर भी टूटे हैं, मज़ार टूटी हैं तो भी मंदिर टूटे हैं, इसमें कोई ऐसी बात नहीं हुई। और यहाँ जबलपुर के लोगों ने बहुत मदद की, इसमें किसी किस्म का दंगा या फसाद हो सकता था, वो कुछ नहीं हुआ है।
To educate the people at large, media was involved, and which undoubtedly played a crucial role in mending the public opinion.
Media ही सबसे अच्छा, सबसे बड़ा, सबसे जबरदस्त रोल प्ले कर सकता है, क्योंकि ये सारी चीजें होती हैं कि आप मानस कैसा तैयार कर रहे हैं आम आदमी का। आप क्या उसको भड़का रहे हैं, क्या आप उसको समझा रहे हैं, क्या आप उसको बता रहे हैं कि ये जो कुछ भी डेवलपमेंट काम हो रहा है उसके हित के लिए हो रहा है। निश्चित तौर से ये बहुत आस्था का सवाल होता है, संवेदनाओं का सवाल होता है, लोगों की भावना जुड़ी होती है, तो कोई भी कम्युनिटी हो इसके लिए बहुत आसानी से तैयार नहीं होती है। लेकिन इसके बावजूद अगर मीडिया अच्छा रोल प्ले करे, ठीक ढंग से लोगों की बात सामने आए, वो प्रशासन को भी समय समय पर समझाई देते रहे कि आपको क्या करना चाहिए क्या नहीं करना चाहिए, लोगों को कॉन्फिडेंस में लेते रहे, उनको बताए कि नहीं देखिए ये जो कुछ भी काम हो रहा है बहुत सा सम्मान हो रहा है, इसमें कोई आप किसी भी तरीके से समझौते नहीं किए जा रहे हैं, तो मेरे को लगता है शायद उसमें कोई दिक्कत नहीं आएगी। और मानस तैयार करने में, मैं बार बार बोल रहा हूँ, माइंड मेकअप करने में मीडिया ही सिर्फ एक बड़ा मेजर रोल प्ले कर सकता है।
Also were used occasions like road safety week to drive home the point. Various surveys and reports related to such structures often being the cause of road accidents were publicized with the help of media. Various accidents related statistics were presented to make the people realize the drawback of letting such encroachments amidst them. So much so that to score points, some speakers at road safety functions started blaming the administration for letting such structures exist and making public suffer. Administration was smiling without letting it come on their faces, for objectives were achieved. Bigger problem was tackling the people with hidden agenda, which have mostly nothing to do with the public good. So identifying the man behind the curtain was a must. As when it comes to high value urban land, big stakes are involved. Local police station level meetings were organized to fathom the kind of likely reactions and who all could be the people. After identification of the men behind the curtain, matter was discussed with him. And in most cases, just cajoling or convincing worked, but sometimes threatening them of legal action was also employed.
You'll expect the senior citizens to have more religiosity and greater faith and more commitment to religion, you know, and more attachment to the idols that were removed. By and large, a concerned citizenry, which is interested in the development of the town as well as development of the country. And they understand the problems. And they understand where they should obstruct and where they should construct. You know. And the wisdom of administration and Mr. Sanjay Dubey was that he approached these people and he convinced them. And he talked to them and he made them resource people and he asked them how it should be done and gave them leadership. दिस इज वॉट इज रिक्वायर्ड राइट. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ऑल क्यूडोज एंड प्रेज टू संजय. He must have convinced himself that this is a necessary step.
Having done that, the next step was of convincing the stakeholders from the public. These were an informal organization and representation from all walks of life that exercise control over their communities, groups, associations and constituencies of local leaders. They included respectable citizens practicing different religions. Several rounds of meetings of the Peace Committee were held to decide the modalities of removal of religious structures. Also, as it happens in many cases, there were people opposing to the very idea of demolition. Besides making positive opinion about the need of demolition of religious structures, such meetings were also used to dilute the opposing voices. At these meetings, negotiations were done at least at three levels for each and every structure falling on a road. All the reservations regarding selection, process and timings of demolitions were sorted out. Though armed with people's support, administration wasn't taking it easy. That was just half the battle. Now came the actual demolition. And to avoid any unseen repercussion, administration needed to have an impeccable plan. So equally important were issues related to demolition and quick development activities on the reclaimed lands. District administration knew that the entire process must be accomplished with military precision and nothing should be left to chance. Every demolition was meticulously planned to the last detail. Along with summoning the additional police force, executive magistrates and police officers too were briefed about the minutest of necessary details.
ये जो सांप्रदायिक स्थिति के संदर्भ में भी आपको उसका विशेष ध्यान रखना है. आपने वो स्थान चिन्हित किए कि जहां जहां संवेदनशीलता ज्यादा है.
Police force was briefed beforehand about locations, sensitive nature of the areas and other possibilities. And quick reaction teams were geared up and kept ready to meet any challenge. Forces were also deployed in other sensitive areas which may have possible repercussions. For each and every demolition site, planning was done afresh and all the requisite men, machine or material needed were evaluated and augmented in advance.
In fact, the good thing or the best thing about all this encroachment removal or removal of religious structures which have come in the way of traffic, you know, that firstly the society at large from all the religious sections were taken into confidence and a system is placed.